By the power vested in me by the laws of the great state of West Virginia and by the laws of the Lord God, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Preston, you may now kiss your bride. The bride and groom would like to exchange now their own personal vows.
We finally made it. We're finally here at our wedding day. The day you've been hinting at, slash talking about, slash prodding me towards for almost 3 years now. But let me tell you, those have been the best 3 years of my life. Sam, you've become my best friend, my partner in crime, literally and figuratively. And most of all, you're my one true love. Today, today, I promise myself and the rest of my life, the most beautiful, caring, sweetest, and sometimes funniest woman I've ever I definitely do not deserve someone as amazing as you, but I promise to show you with words and actions every day for the rest of our lives how amazing you are to me and how much I love you. I promise to fight with everything in me to provide the best that I can for you and our future family. I pray that I can be half the dad that your dad was to you and my dad was to me. I promise to be the spiritual leader of our home and family, as this is the most important promise that I can make to you and everyone we know and everyone we meet. As Joshua said, we will be able to say, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord.
Amen.
Seth, you have already changed me for the better in so many ways, and I'm sure you will continue to do so in the coming days. There are a few things I hate to say you won't be able to change about me. I promise to always kill the spiders and chase you with them afterwards. I promise to always stand for America and Israel, because in the words of the great late Merrill Haggard, when you're walking on my country, man, or when you're talking about my country, man, you're walking on the fight inside of me. Steph, I love you, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you.
Yeah.
Preston, a little while before God brought you to me, I wrote down a list of 10 qualities I absolutely had to have in my husband. And I prayed for that man. Now I know that God has a sense of humor, because not only did he give me a man with these 10 qualities, but he gave me a man with these qualities to the extreme. I entitled it Husband Checklist, and it goes as follows. 1, is God first in his life? 2, goes to church. 3, loves his family. 4, attractive. 5, athletic, but not in love with sports. 6, a man. That's pretty important. 7, I should have left this one out. Has his own opinion. 8, mature but fun. That one's a little iffy. 9, funny. And 10, a gentleman. I did write a number 11 down, but it was left blank. I know now that it was meant for your name. Thank you so much for being the man with these 11 qualities and hundreds of other qualities that I hadn't even known I needed in my husband. You make me so unbelievably happy, and I only hope that I can make you anywhere as near as happy as I am. I promise to love you forever. I promise to always be your best friend. I promise to have all the adventures with you. I promise to always be faithful. I promise to let you ride the motorcycle sometimes. And I promise to strive with you to put God first in our home. I love you, Preston Kendrick.
I, Preston.
I, Savannah.
Offer myself completely to you.
Savannah. Preston.
To be your husband in marriage.
To be your wife in marriage.
I promise to love you. With all of my heart. And to be true and faithful. I promise to stand beside you. I dedicate our marriage. To the Lordship of Jesus Christ. I pledge myself and all that I am in love. By the power vested in me by the laws of the great state of West Virginia, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Preston, you may now kiss your bride.
Country roads. Preston Savannah, Kendricks.
West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home, country roads. Country roads.
Love.